Hello, my name is Maxim Ivanov, and today we'll be talking about promises. In JavaScript, promises are special sort of objects that serve a proxy for data that is initially unknown. The concept is not unique for JavaScript. Similar constructs exist in other languages as well. They exist in Java, Python, C++, and other languages, and depending on language, they are known by different names like futures, deferreds, delays, and other. The term promise was proposed in 1976 by Daniel P. Friedman and David Weiss in a paper called The Impact of Applicative Programming on Multiprocessing. Promises are used to process results of asynchronous operations. Let's say we have some code that has a callback to process operation asynchronously. We can remake it into a promise. Here is a function that takes number of milliseconds as delay and then creates new promise that will be resolved after specified time will pass. Here we used method then on promise instance to perform some operation after the promise was resolved. Coolest part is that since ES6 you can use async await to handle promises. Here we have same promise set timeout function definition, but now we can use await to wait for promise to be resolved. This makes asynchronous code that uses promises look like it's synchronous. So our code execution will stay on this line until this promise will be resolved, and then we'll log async operation. Essentially, promises can have three different states. Promise can be pending, its initial state of any promise. Promise can be resolved. This is state which promise becomes after operation was performed successfully. Or promise can end up being rejected when operation it was performing failed. Promises cannot change state arbitrarily. After promise was resolved or rejected, it cannot become pending again. When instantiated, promise accepts an executor function. Executor function is executed immediately after promise is instantiated. This executor function accepts two arguments, two callbacks, resolve and reject. And then inside of it, you can perform some asynchronous code. If the asynchronous operation was performed successfully, it should call the callback resolve. Like in this example, we call async success. After calling resolve inside the executor, promise will change its state to resolved. Promise provides method then to get the result of successful execution. If asynchronous operation failed, you can also call reject inside of the executor. In this case, promise will become rejected. Promise provides method catch to handle rejection. Promise instance also provides method finally that will be called regardless of successful fulfillment or rejection of the promise. Methods then and catch return promises, so you can chain them. In this example, after our initial promise is resolved, we call then, log the result, add one to our number, and return it from our then callback. And then we repeat it a couple of times. Every time in each then block, we will get result of previous function execution. So each callback is executed sequentially. But we can also add multiple then callbacks to a single promise. In this example, all then callbacks are applied to our original promise, so they will be executed independently. Promise also provides static methods. For example, promise resolve. This method returns resolved promise with given value. This method is used when you need to wrap an already known value into a promise. Promise reject returns already rejected promise with an error. Promise all accepts an iterable container of promises, usually an array, and returns a new promise that will be resolved when all the promises in this container, array, will be resolved. The resolved promise will contain results of all the resolved promises in the past array. The resolved values will keep the order in which corresponding promises were passed into promise all. As you can see, first promise will actually resolve the last because it has biggest timeout, but it still will be the first in our results. There is also method promise race that also takes an iterable, usually an array, but instead of returning an array of results, it returns first resolved promise. So in our example where we pass three promises with three different delays and the last one will actually resolve first, our promise race, return promise, will resolve with the result our third promise. So in this video we saw how promises worked. We've learned that promise is a container for the value that is not yet known, and it is used for asynchronous programming. We've learned that promises can have three states: pending, resolved, and rejected. And we've also learned some methods to work with promises, ones that you can call on promise instance, and static methods that you can call on promise class itself. If you have questions, leave them in the comments below, and if you like this video, press like button and don't forget to subscribe to the channel.